Hello everyone, this is Paolo again, and this is yet another draft video. And this time, the two best cards are the Flashy Tree Imp and the Go for the Throat. And I have no reservations to being infected. In fact, I would like to. I think it's the best archetype. And in this deck, the Imp is just a much better card than the Go for the Throat. So that's what I'm gonna pick. And there is not really much else to see in this pack. There is no debate, really. The rare is not good, so I'll just take the flashy dream. Even if that means I'm gonna make the person to my left go black too, because the next best card is to go for the throat, I don't really care much about that. Now at this point, I would rather have a card with infect, but there is none. And even if I do go green black, none of those cards is particularly good in infect. So I'm just gonna take what is by far the best card here, the Burned Imp here. And I might splash it, I might not play the Imp, I might not play the Burn, or I might play Red Black Infect or not. But it's just feels like it's just better value. Here again, there is no Infect. There is a Gruesome Encore, though, if you want to make any jokes. This pack is extremely alike the pack that I opened. In fact, I think those might be the exact commons that I just opened. Which is pretty weird. Like, all of them. But anyway, I think the best card here. I don't like Mirsire much in a build that doesn't have, like, infinite vivisections. Drosshopper is okay, but he's not super good. The Skyhunter is good in the Y-Wing deck that I don't like and probably not gonna draft. So I think the Treasure Mage is just the best card here. It has the best possible value. Like, if I get a good expensive artifact is going to be really good, and nothing else has the potential to be really good. And this is a combination that I like, any sort of like Grixis splashing 100. No, this is really bad for me too. I think the options here are the Mirror Welder, the Vivisection, and the Mirsire. I think both Vivisection and Mirror Welder are better than Mirsire, so it's between those two. As I said, I do like Mirror Welder, as I said in my article, I mean, but I think Vivisection is a little bit better. Here we have Equal Wellspring or Quicksilver Geyser, or the 3-3 Infect. I think Infect is not shaping up to be what I want at this point. So I think I'm just gonna go with Equal Wellspring, which is probably a better card than the Geyser in a deck that I could play either, but it's definitely better if I don't play blue. No, it's actually, well, here I might just pick the rats because the other cards are not good enough. Though this is the 10th reading emissary that I passed, just for the record. I think I just pick the rats here instead of the Fuel for the Cause because this card is not very good, so I might as well. Okay, now here I'm just picking the Rotwolf and seeing what happens. I can always splash Treasure Mage or Burning Fury if I want, depending. And there is yet another greedy emissary, but Rotwolf is just so much better than Digest, but I think it's worth it not being able to play it if I don't play green. Here there is a big guy or hate drafting this 3-1 that I'm not gonna play. I think there's a bigger chance that I want to play the Worm than that I want to like hedgehog everything. So yeah, this is my original pack. It really did have all those same cards. I'm gonna pick the Tangle Mantis here. And probably the Tangle Mantis for the next pack too. Training Drone is really bad, but it's between I think Banishment Decree and the Boat, and I think the Boat is a more troublesome card. And here I will play none of those cards for sure. I just pick the one that might beat me for some reason. It's like because of both. I doubt I'll ever play it, but I did lose the game to that card in the Pro Tour. Not the boat. The boat's actually good. The rally, the forces, or whatever it is. And again, I'll take the boat. Yeah, so far my deck does not look like the best deck ever. That is often the case, I guess. with my decks in the first pack. Here, my options are Volusia Reign, Stratocide, and Trigon of Corruption. Yeah, those three cards are much better than anything else in the pack, I feel. I really like Black Trigon, and I think at this point the Black Trigon would be better than the Volusia Reign, because I don't know if they're gonna play the Volusia Reign. But I think Stratocide is just a better. It's more powerful, so I'll just take it. Yeah, here I will just take the Plague Stinger. I think Plague Stinger is better than Necropete. And at this point, I might as well like commit to Infect of sorts. You don't need many Infect guys to have an Infect deck. But yeah, I think this is better than Necropete, especially because I have Stratocide. And this is a Skin Render. Now, I'm taking the Skin Render, but am I gonna wheel something? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I might wheel Blade Opinions or Blight Mambar and take my Orange to Infection or Silver Crab Lagoon. Or even this, yeah. Yeah, all those cards except for Golden Urn and I guess Daredevil are cards that people might play. And even like Blade Tribe Berserkers. So I'll probably wheel something. Hopefully it will be the Blight Mambar. Here I have Wrath, Tanglefort. Well, let's just hide those two cards unless I get Contagion Engine or Wurmcow Engine or Mere Battlesphere. I'm not gonna play blue. It's between Infiltration Lands and Wall and Tainted Strike. I feel like Infiltration Lands is pretty good in Infect. So, and I still have time to get like more two drops or something. It's not like the other deck where I knew I was gonna be more control-ish. Here it's between Pain's Mist and Stone Infection. I think Instant Infection is a better card. I don't have many artifacts, and I don't plan on having many artifacts. Here, I don't want to play any of the artifact cards, so I just pick Throwing Board, and again, I might play it if I play the Treasure Mage, but probably not. But Burning Pure is better than Throwing Board. Still, again, not anything that I would want to play. And I can either take the Disperse or the Steady Progress. I will just take Steady Progress, I think it's better. At this point, I don't have any green. So, yeah, I'm gonna take the 2-1 play here. So I might as well just not play green and play blue instead. That's definitely a possibility. If I do, though, play green, I think Azuri Archers is a better card in the board than the Scrap Diver Serpent would be. So I didn't wield the Blight Mamba. I did wield the Triumph Infestation, which is, I guess, good enough. It is the worst card that I could have wielded, probably. Yeah, at this point, there's an actual chance that I go blue, black, red, Infect. But because the only good green card that I have is Rubble, really. At least I got a target for my Treasure Mage. Well, I guess I found my target. This is obviously not the best in an Infect deck, but it will do. It is definitely better than anything that I have here. If I had like a more powerful Infect card, I'd take it, but this is just. So at this point, blue is looking a lot better than green. Yeah, this is tough. Yeah, that's probably the worst card I could be passed in terms of not knowing what to do. I could always splash Treasure Mage to get to Hawkeye and maybe some Proliferators, but then I cannot splash Burning Pure. So the choice would be Rotwolf and Putrefax against Ikarat, which is not even that good. Yeah, I think I have to take the Putrefact here. Even if it means I don't play the Treasure Mage or the Burning Pure. And here I take the Plague Sting, which is better than Ichor Claw Mirror. Yeah, I think I have to take Entangmite here. It's good if my two Blitzingers at least. And here, well, I'm gonna take Krasn Spell Bomb so I can splash whichever of the two I need to splash. I do not have a whole lot of playables here. Like, I might as well remove the Equal Offspring, it's just not good. Yeah, here I take Palladium here, but it's not even good in my deck. Cross Sword. Can I splash both colors? I doubt that really. So which one is better? I think in an Infect deck, Burning Pure might be better, but if I have Burning Pure, I cannot. Like, I can get Steady Progress and Treasure Mage. Yeah, I really do need levels. Another Forecasting Quest card is not what I hope for, but it will have to do. I'm also gonna play this Tower of Defiance. Because, Living Weapon and stuff. Yeah, this is pretty annoying. Why couldn't I have been past, like, Skitradix or Carnifex Demon instead of Petrifex? I guess. Yeah, I don't really have enough. So I do if I play Steady Progress. It's funny how the foil robots looks blue to me. Here we have it. Yeah, I'm not gonna play two withstand that, so I might as well take the Moria Creeper against other Infect people. So yeah, my deck looks like a deck that could win. I mean, I have two Plaguestingers and a Flash Hitter him, and then I have Entangmite and Stratocide, which is a very good combo with those. And I have a Petrifex. And I have a Steel Hawkeye. And perhaps a Treasure Mage. But perhaps a Burning. Here I could take Golem if I play Burning here, but that seems just worse than Tesla's last Defiance. I'll just take all the Defiances and hope I play against. I might play it. I hope I play against someone with a lot of Living Weapon. Even though I don't recall passing many. Most of them are pretty good, so they wouldn't have come barely. At least the good ones are pretty good. So let's see what I have. Yeah, not playing that. Oh, Ichor Wellspring. There is no point. So this is 20 playables. So my options here are I play Burning Pure, or I play, well, it would be Burning Pure, Tangle Mantis, and Withstand Death, most likely. Or I can play Treasure Mage, Steady Progress, and Thrumming Bird. Is Steady Progress even better than the dissection? Steady Progress kind of, it's obviously worse than a Thrumming Bird, but it looks like more of a card that I want to splash. Because I really want to cast Thrumming Bird early. I don't want to cast Thrumming Bird during 10. But I would not mind. I would not mind, I don't think, casting Steady Progress during 10. So, but 10 is Vivisection. I would not mind casting Vivisection. I didn't know Vivisection and Petrifex. Yeah, I think I have to go with the blue here. But what? What other cards do I want? I don't want to play the Tangle Mantis because I have a lot of foils already. And I can definitely cut the Tesla's Defiance if it comes to that. It might be just worse. Do I want the Vivisection? I don't have much that I want to sacrifice. I mean, I have the Trigon token. And I have. Yeah, I don't really want, like, Treasure Mage. Palladium maybe. I don't really want to sack a lot of stuff, so I might. I think I'm just gonna play those. That will give me like a decent curve. I have three blue cards, so I have like three islands with a spell bomb should be fine. I don't have a lot of green. So let's say I play three islands. That leaves me 14 lands, so I can play 7/7. Is 7-7 better than 6-4 than 8-6? I think it is. There are two more black cards, but green has Horizon Spell Bomb and two Tal'Dorei's Defiance. This kind of sucks that my Strata side is not gonna be very good because I don't have a lot of lands of the same type, but they probably have one of the ones that I want. Having an island in my deck is probably better where Strata side is concerned than having an extra forest or swamp, because I have the option of searching for it. But yeah, for the record, I am not happy with this. With splashing a strategy progress and turning board. I guess I could just splash Treasure Mage. And then I get to cut like this, and then I get to play a Wasteland Death perhaps. Let's see if I can make this running pure. I feel like Colin was doing this. So I have one island, one mountain. That will really get them with Strata side. If I have like four forests, four swamps in play, and I have seven mountains, and I play Strata side and get a mountain, that'll be very surprising for them. And then I need two more lands. No, sorry. Yeah, I could play two of each of those. If I had another fixer, I would probably do this. But as it is, maybe I play this and I play Enchain Lands. How does that look? Yeah, I don't know. No, I think playing the Burning Pier here is just way too greedy. But I could cut one of those and then play an extra swamp. Then I get to play maybe Ichor Wellspring to cantrip. There's actually nothing that works with it, right? Yeah, not a single card. Oh, Steel Hellguide. It's the only card that kind of works with Ichor Wellspring. Steady Progress or just a guy. I think I'll play just a guy. The thing is, if I play just a guy, I don't really want it to be a 4 casting cost guy. It might as well be a 7 casting cost guy. But I already have Steel Hellguide and Treasure Mage for Steel Hellguide. So, yeah, I think I'll just play it with Wasteland Death here. It's probably better. I do have two Tal'Dorei's Defiance already, and I don't want to flood it with this kind of card. But it's not bad with the goblins, and especially with the imp, it's really good with the imp. So yeah, I'll play this, and then I'll play two islands. Even if, like, Turning Board still looks better than Steady Progress, even if I don't have 2 hours to cast it. And I'll add a swamp now. Yeah, that looks the best course of action to me. I might be wrong. I mean, I'm not really sure of anything I'm doing. It's possible that Treasure Mage and Turning Board are just worse than Burning Pew in my deck. But we'll see how this goes.